All right, guys, if you didn't know, in exactly 1 month, there is the annual Ajax System event. So they always do an annual event to reveal what products they will release in the next year. So it's called Rule Your Space. It will happen on October 20th. And well, to celebrate this event, we wanted to look at what they released in the past year. One product particularly we think didn't get enough exposure. So we want to review it with you today. So we're gonna talk about the Life Quality. It's the air monitoring sensor from Ajax. We're gonna look at it, if it can be useful for you, how it works, and how to enroll it in your Ajax systems. All right, let's get to it. All right, guys, so what is the Life Quality? The Life Quality is Ajax released it in the past year. It comes in their comfort and productivity category of products, so all inside their smart home products. Yes, normally we more talk about security products in the way like security cameras, access control, alarms, but we thought it would be a good idea to review an air sensor simply because it's about securing your environment, securing the air you're breathing in and out, because it can be dangerous for your health if you're exposed to it to a long period of time. So, what does it monitor exactly? This sensor will monitor the CO2 in the air, the temperature, and the humidity. Some example for calculating the temperature and humidity, well, think about leaving a window open. Here in Montreal, it's kind of a concrete jungle, so it can get really hot and really cold in the span of 24 hours. So leaving the Life Quality near the window, it can send a notification to your phone if, for example, you left it open during the night, so the temperature starts lowering down to -5 degrees. So you don't want to have the cold air come inside, so it reminds you to close your window before you go to bed. And humidity, well, it's the same problem, because again, in a concrete jungle, when it's getting really hot outside, it creates a lot of humidity in the air. That means that if outside there's more humidity than inside your home, when you open the window, you bring in the humidity inside your home, and that in long time can create molds in the wall and can also affect your way of breathing. So it can be a problem in the long term. So again, if you set your threshold to have it over 70% of humidity in the air, well, you will receive a notification, and from there you're reminded to close the windows. Now, what about the CO2 sensor? Well, there is a lot of air sensor in the market that use different kind of sensor, and they're not really optimal to calculate it. But in the Life Quality from Ajax, it's actually a medical grade sensor. So it's really precise and it's really good to use. And the CO2, well, it's kind of a hidden threat in the air because it's all around us at all times, but it's not always a health risk. I'm going to show you a little graphic on the Ajax website to explain more in details what I mean by that. If you go on Ajax Systems under the Life Quality specifications, you will find a chart that explains what CO2 can do to your health. So they have a chart that they design with different colors that represent also the colors on the application itself. When we look at it, we see that all the green parts mean that it's an acceptable level of parts per million CO2 in the air. But as soon as you go up to the yellow, red, and purple, you can also see the risk of the CO2 in the air when it's more concentrated, like we see if it reached over 1000 ppm. So when we're looking at yellow, well, it can create sneezing, coughing, you can have eye irritation, and so on. When it's red, well, now we're talking about headaches, dizziness, tiredness. And when it's purple, well, honestly, just run away. It means it's really dangerous right now. Now, you may never notice that CO2 can affect you because it's kind of a new product. Air sensors weren't really popular back then. Now they're entering the market. You see them left and right. So why would you need that right now? Well, if we're talking about CO2, like we just showed in this graph, it directly affects your productivity. So that means that during a day of work, for example, in the office, you can get more tired than usual and you don't really know why. Well, it can be the effect of CO2. And simply put, CO2, we create it. It's not something that comes from all around pollution. I'm gonna explain it really fast for you to understand. So when we eat food, food is created to create energy. That's how we move ourselves, that's how we're getting active during the day. So when we create this energy inside of us, it creates little small puffs of CO2. So we're full of CO2, but we don't need it to stay alive, to just function as a whole. So what happens is when we breathe in the oxygen that we need, we actually breathe out the CO2. So we release the CO2 in the air, and that's where you get the parts per million. One person releasing CO2 is not a problem, but in an office, if you're having a meeting with maybe 10 people, that's where it can be dangerous if your area is not well ventilated. And that's where the life quality can come in handy to remind you to maybe open up a window, go for a walk, open a door, because again, it affects directly your productivity. So we did a little test to show you how exactly the CO2 works. Like, we just gave you an example, but we actually had people tested out the life quality to design a graph to show you how it's represented in the Ajax system app. So I tested it myself by putting it in my bedroom, closing up the doors, closing out the windows, so you can see the variation of CO2 in the room itself. So when you open the app, you would be able to see the graphics of the CO2. Now, we're gonna look at it more in details later, but right now you can see that what the graphic looks like in my bedroom 3 days ago. As you can see, it is an acceptable level of PPM in the air, but then it goes down when the doors are open, and you can see rise up to a high level of PPM as soon as I close the doors. And it goes up and down all the way through the night. And when you go to another day, so here specifically, this is when I actually open the windows. So it raises up to a high level of PPM. And as soon as I open the windows, well, it dropped to 400 PPM, all the way down from 1,400 PPM. What I'm trying to show here is that, yes, CO2 can be harmful to your health long-term, but it's also really easy to just remove the CO2 from the air. All you need to do is open up the windows, open up your doors, maybe walk out for 5 minutes, and it should be fine. So don't be alarmed by if you're having a notification that there's too much CO2 in the air, because again, it's really easy to work around it. And that's what the life quality is good about. It's a reminder to tell you to put an action to remove the CO2 in the air. One of the nicest features of the life quality is actually, well, like most Ajax products, it's wireless. So you can travel with it, you can put it in your bag, you can put it in your car, you can travel with it. And the idea behind this is that Ajax integrated a 72-hour data inside the life quality. That means that wherever you put it, so right now I had it in my home, and now I bring it to the office. That means I can record for 72 hours the amount of humidity, the temperature, and the CO2 levels in my office space. So when I come back near the hub, it will sync up my life quality device, send it to the application, and I can see the different variation of all these that were monitored inside the life quality. So I can see if, well, the CO2 levels are at an acceptable rate, the humidity levels, and the temperature too. I can then adjust them if I realize that, well, we had a meeting during this period of time, so I see a high peak in my graph. Well, that means that, well, during that meeting, it may be better to open up the windows. So every time I have a meeting now, I open up the windows. Just simply, again, to not affect productivity of everyone, because it's something we don't see. We don't realize there's CO2 in the air. So it's always better to just keep in mind that it can affect us, even if we don't realize it. With that said, what does it actually look like inside the Ajax system app? Well, we're gonna look at it right now. Normally, you would have to enroll it to your hub, but you can look at one of our previous video where we went through all the steps on how to enroll the Ajax products. It's the same for every product. It's really simple, and honestly, it's one of the main factors why Ajax is so popular. All right, now we're in the application. As you can see, we see the temperature here, the humidity level, and the CO2 levels. so it's well represented directly in the front of the application when you click on your Life Quality. You can then go into details of all of them, and this is where you see the chart appearing. You can put it by the hours, daily, weekly. So if you have a lot of data, it's easy to find the correct data in your application. Now we're in the temperature, humidity, CO2. So as you can see again, really easy to navigate through the application. If you click on the little cogwheel on the top, this is where you can actually set up the notification notice through the Life Quality to your cell phone. What that means is that, for example, here, air monitor settings, you will click on the temperature, you set the low bar of temperature, so when it goes below 20 degrees, this is when you would get a notification. And if it goes higher than 25 degrees, it's the same thing, you would also get a notification. So you set the threshold of, again, temperature, humidity, and CO2 level directly on the application. One that is interesting is actually the CO2 level, because you have the same chart that we just saw on the Ajax Systems website. Again, it's set at 1000 ppm because that's the recommended ppm in the air, so you remain healthy and it doesn't affect your health. Now, if we navigate again through it, you have the notifications here. So you can set when the value changed for the CO2 level, humidity, temperature, but not necessarily. You can disactivate them and maybe just put for the CO2 level, because for humidity and temperature, well, you don't want to be bothered all the time, because in your place, it may vary a lot. Another nice feature about the Life Quality is that if you have it in an office space, maybe not everyone is connected to the application. So you have a LED indicator. If we look at the Life Quality right here, when you push at the center, it will light up to the actual ppm of the air. So it means that green, we're at a great level of CO2 in the air, it won't affect our health. Now, something to note here is that you cannot actually set the LED indicators for all the settings. So it cannot do it for temperature, humidity, and CO2 at the same time. You have to choose one aspect, and this is what will show when you push the Ajax logo on the Life Quality. Also, always remember to calibrate your CO2 sensor before placing it. So it may change room. So you put it in your bedroom, you calibrate it, you put it in your office. Remember to calibrate it again, because the airflow might be different in all those spaces. Okay, with all that said, what is our thoughts about the Life Quality? Well, first off, if you have a smart home and you're already in the Ajax ecosystem, well, we think it's a great addition to this system. Again, it's about securing your space and your environment. And look at the air quality, well, we think it's a good thing to keep it in mind that it may affect your health. But what about you guys? We're mostly talking about security, but smart homes are getting more and more popular. So what do you think about them? Is it something you go and see in the long run that everybody will have in their house in the future? Or do we see it maybe as a downhill trend that people will move away from? Please let us know in the comment below. So we just said that it would be good in the Ajax ecosystem, but what about our recommendation for this product? Well, honestly, there's some small tweaks Ajax could do with the Life Quality to make it way better than it is right now. A nice thing would be to add a soundbite, so when the threshold is reached or you go over it, the Life Quality itself will emit a sound to let you know that there's too much CO2, for example, in the air, rather than receiving an alarm on your phone, because maybe you don't have your phone on you when this happens. Another nice feature would be to add colors in the graphs, so you don't have to look at the highest point all the time. You can see the colors go high, so it's yellow, it's green when it goes down. So we have a better idea of the whole situation just by looking at the first glance at the application. And finally, another nice thing would be to be able to connect the Life Quality, maybe through Bluetooth to your phone. So not being always in reach of your hub. I think this will give you more freedom on how to use it. You can leave it in your office space for a longer period of time. And it helps you actually monitor multiple different locations for your personal health. Thank you guys for watching. Again, if you are a manufacturer of professional security products and you would like us to do maybe a tutorial or a review of a new product you have in store, well, hit us up, send us an email, call us, and we'll make sure to help you elevate your brand. For you guys installers, technicians out there, well, leave us a comment below if you like this video and give us feedback if you would want another video to come to light about a certain product. All right, guys, thank you and see you later.